Welcome back to Time Now 644. It's the best show on tracks. Hundreds of antique tractors are on display in Knight's Landing this weekend.
KCRA3's Brian Hickey joins us live again. And Brian, you actually had an opportunity to drive one of the old tractors.
I'll tell you, that is such a cool experience to drive one of these old machines. The fact that they still run, and honestly, they don't make them like they used to. We can clearly say that. This is such a cool event. You know, we've been watching tractors over the last couple of weeks, working out here in the boat section of I-5. We wouldn't have these tractors if it wasn't for these tractors that I'm about to show you. 400 historic tractors all on display in Knight's Landing this weekend. A great place to take the family and check out history.
You are looking at a time machine.
I have built this whole thing except for the crankshaft.
At least that's what Don Hunter calls his steam-powered track layer.
This is a replica of the first Holt Caterpillar sold. It represents a tractor of 1906.
To say Don built this tractor from the ground up is an understatement. He had a crankshaft to work with, and some 20,000 hours later, he has rebuilt history.
Work from pictures, and actually, there's quite a bit of information. There's a book at Caterpillar.
Holt tractors were first built in Stockton, California. These machines were the cutting edge of farming technology.
At the time this tractor came out, most people were farming with mules and horses.
In San Leandro, another company called Best was also building tractors.
Walk that flywheel over.
Steam quickly gave way to gas. This is a 1919 Best 75. With power steering and differential rear end, it could do the work of 75 horses.
We're going to put you in gear.
Put the clutch in?
No, not yet.
Okay.
Just pull it back and you'll see everything start to turn down there.
What does this mean to you to hear an old machine like this fired up?
Well, this is stuff I grew up on. When I was 8 years old, my grandfather bought me my first antique tractor. So this is like home to me.
The show starts at 7 o'clock this morning, so just a few minutes from right now, and runs all through the weekend. Some 400 tractors. For more information on how to get there and all that good stuff, kcra.com/morningnews. You'll find a link under the news link section there for you. Now let's go up to Ryan Dish in Live Copter 3 HD. He is over the site of this big event this weekend, the Dan Best Ranch, the grandson of the Best Tractor Company. Ryan, a lot of history in this area with these tractors. What are you seeing up there?
Oh, a lot of history in the area with these tractors. This looks like just quite a great event. You can see a lot of the old nostalgic tractors from the industrial area all posted up here. This guy fired his up just a little while ago. We were watching the steam come out of it. I mean, it's just a really, really neat thing to watch. And all these machines that have been around for such a long time and were such an important part to the history of the Central Valley. You know, there's those Caterpillar tractors, and you've heard the name Benjamin Holt, and actually the road Benjamin Holt in Stockton was named after the gentleman that created the Caterpillar tractor. And really quickly, one of the big successes of that tractor was that tank tread. You see that big tank tread on there? The reason they created that was because all the tractors with the smaller wheels were getting stuck out in the Delta. When they came up with the tank tread, they didn't get stuck anymore, and that's added to the success of the Delta tractor. Back to you.
A lot of really cool stuff on display up there. Thanks, Ryan, Live Copter 3. And so you can go out there and check it out this weekend. See a lot of interactive displays. They'll be plowing, they'll be cutting, they'll be pushing dirt, doing it all up there. So again, ksra.com/morningnews to check out the best show on tracks. People coming from around the world to take it in. Back to you guys.
Hey, Brian, aren't some of those tractors worth quite a bit of money?
They're priceless today. In fact, the one tractor that I drove, the gas-powered one, is only one of six. The guy said, I hope you enjoy that because you just drove the Maserati of antique tractors.
That is so cool.
I get to do it again in the 7 o'clock hour, so we'll be back out there playing on some farm equipment.
All right, Brian, always having fun. Thanks so much.